a site that is running the editorially accessibility checker. And one of the first things you'll see is that you don't see it. So this is something that's only viewed by logged in editors for a website. It's not an overlay for the general public. It's also not a comprehensive tool. So this is not something that is, say, competing with a tool like Wave, where it's going to find issues all over the page and really help you make your theme, your code, your design accessible. That's not what this is for. This is for the content editors on the site who are editing the text to help them not make common mistakes. So let's look at what that might look like. This is a Drupal site. This is looking at the Drupal version of the module. So here's the editing interface for a page, so they can put some text in here, things like that. If they save this page, what's going to happen is immediately there's going to be a quick check run, and if any new issues are found, it's going to pop open a little panel. And boom! So this page was saved, and it says two manual checks are needed. Show first. Oh, we'll click that. And it says possible list item prefix. Number one, list formatting is more than simple, so it tells browsers how to group content that breaks over multiple lines, etc. So what you're seeing here is it's flagging this, saying yeah, this should have been a list, not just spelled out numbers, and then giving a very short, simple, non-technical explanation of the problem. And that's really what this is for. This is for the non-technical user to teach them the basics of good content structure and just provide sort of a live spell check. Next, it says manual check needed, link title may be generic. So click here, link, that sort of thing. So moving on, if you have a page that has nothing, you see just this little friendly toggle. Very nice. Either way, if you click the toggle, it'll open or close. So here again, we can make all that go away. And it has some little extra tools there, show tags. So here you can see the page structure, all the headers, and it illustrates them in line. It also shows you alt tags for images and things like that, and it'll overlay those on the images too. So here you can see a little alt text overlay. It makes all that visible. You can shrink this down, get it out of your way as you're looking around, or just get rid of it and back to normal. On pages with a lot of errors, it's going to turn red. So this is a demo you can see on GitHub. And now we see there's a lot going on here. So this shows all the things, including some pretty serious errors. So images that are missing the alt attribute, things like that. And that's it. The point of this is to be quick, simple, straightforward, not get in people's way, not be annoying, but help them from making common mistakes, keep your site accessible, give you a little quality assurance.